Hey guys, it's Mike from the Geek Pub. Today we're going to give a little update on R2-D2 and I'm going to talk to you about my control system. Okay, so when I first went to build my R2-D2, I went and researched all of the forums, and one thing that I found is that most of the people building R2-D2s are using what I would call rehashed 10-year-old technology, and I don't mean that in a bad way because what they're using works well, and it's basically just a rehash of old model airplane controllers. And I wanted my R2-D2 to be based on something more modern so that I could control it via software. So I wanted to be able to use things like Xbox or PlayStation controllers. And I also wanted to be able to interface it with things like iOS and Android apps, as well as maybe even my home automation system. R2-D2 is going to eventually live in my theater room, and I wanted to be able to, when you open the doors of the theater room and you turn things on, I wanted R2-D2 to wake up and do things, and then when you play the movie, I want him to go back to sleep. And so I wanted something a little bit more modern. So the path that I originally went down was simply to use a Raspberry Pi, and I thought, well, the Raspberry Pi has GPIO, and it can run Python and all these things that just make it the perfect little platform for running R2-D2. What it didn't really think about, and as I started doing more research, I realized, so in the dome, for example, there are something like 20 plus servos just to control all of these little bitty parts, the holo projectors and all of those things, and that doesn't even include the displays and the LEDs and all the other stuff that go on in the dome. And so I realized quickly that I was going to need something additional. And so I decided that I was going to do a mix of the Raspberry Pi as the center brain, and then Arduinos sitting in different locations within R2-D2. It's sort of like an octopus. So if you don't know, an octopus has one kind of single master brain, and then it has these little ancillary brains that control each leg. And so the brain kind of sends a command, if you will, to those other brains, and then they figure out how to self-navigate those legs on their own. And so the system that I've built is very similar to that, and I'm going to walk you through it.
Okay, so let's talk about how this control system is put together. First, we start with the Raspberry Pi. This is where my Astromech core software runs. It has all of the subroutines and functions and monitors everything within the R2-D2. It also handles all input devices such as the PS3 controller, my home automation system, or a smartphone app. Since this dome has to move, there's something called a slip ring between it and the body. The slip ring lets a small number of wires pass through, and it allows them to rotate within the head. This keeps the wires from getting tangled, but it also means I have just enough of them for power and data. Due to that limitation, I decided to put an Arduino Mega 2560 in the dome. This Arduino is responsible for controlling all of the devices located inside the dome and reporting their statuses back to the Raspberry Pi. It is connected over the I2C bus using just two wires. In the body is a second Arduino Mega 2560, also connected to the I2C bus. It's responsible for controlling all of the body servos. Also in the body are two motor controllers, one for the dome and one that controls the two drive motors. These are Palula I2C motor controllers and hence also live on the I2C bus. This design makes it very simple to add or remove devices, and I have multiple options for doing it, whether it be GPIO on the Pi, digital I/O on the Arduinos, I2C, or even wireless. Now, the next thing I needed to figure out was how to make all of these devices talk to each other in a consistent manner. What I came up with is a simple Astromech command language, or ACL. It works like this. Every command starts with a pound, or hashtag for you young people. Following that is a single letter that designates something specific. D for dome, B for body, M for media, or Z for motor controller. I'm sure I will add more as I go. I've just recently added S for a sequence of commands so I can make R2-D2 do little shows. Followed behind the command is a string of parameters. For example, pound DDP01OP is the command to open dome panel 1. Pound DHP01CT tells holo projector 1 to center itself. Pound BDD plus 055 tells the dome drive to turn left at a speed setting of 55.
So all of those commands live in what's called a mapping file with inside the Astromech core. And they're all assigned to individual things, like buttons, for example. And this one's assigned to a joystick, which turns the Astromech head. And eventually, like I said, when I have an API, anything, literally anything, will be able to send those commands to R2-D2. Of course, they'll require authentication. So that's a basic update on how my Astromech system works. For those of you who are wondering... Woo! So for those of you who are wondering, I will eventually open source this to the public, but for now it's in such a state of disarray because it's in the early stages, I'm not going to release it. But I suspect within a few months I'll have an early version out there that everyone can use. So that's it for this video. If you want to stick around during the credits, I'm going to give just a little bit of a tour of R2-D2 and talk to you about him. Okay, so for those of you who are wondering, yes, I am making a lot of these parts, and I'm also paying other people to make some of these parts. And so there's a whole forum called astromech.net where you can go, and it's kind of a club, and other people who have the resources will make parts for you. And so I've done some of those, and then I'm making some of my own, and then I'm also just using a local machine shop. There's a machine shop here in Dallas called Dallas CNC, and they've machined a lot of this for me, and they have a website where you can go buy some of it also. But a lot of this stuff, so like for example, these are the speakers. They might be kind of hard to see. They're just off-the-shelf speakers that I got off of Amazon. Like some of these motor controllers and motors and stuff. And by the way, a lot of this stuff is simply double-sided taped on because I'm not sure that it's in its final location. I'm just experimenting with things. And so the dome, for example, is made from out of a guy, I think he's in Ohio, if I'm not, sorry if I got that wrong. It's granite earth, and he's got a big hydroforming machine and a laser, 3D laser cutter that will cut out all of these little pieces and parts. You can see here there's one missing, so you can kind of get an idea how it all goes together. There's another one missing over here, and they're down here because I haven't actually glued them on. They're just double-sided taped because, again, I'm experimenting. I want to make sure I can take things apart. Same thing for the holo projectors. There's another guy who's got a machine that's just specialized enough to make these. And so those things you just can't make. There's no possible way I'm going to make those on the X carve. It might make them, but it would probably take, you know, a week to cut one part, and I just don't have time to wait for it. So here's some horseshoes that'll go around the legs. I'm working on getting the LDP ready to paint blue, which goes, you know, right underneath the dome on the front. Then I've got some other parts, so like here's the front vents. Again, Dallas CNC machined those for me out of a solid piece of aluminum. They look absolutely beautiful. I will tell you, none of this stuff is cheap. Here's some more parts that I had made, the coin slots and the coin returns. That's what they're called in the R2-D2 land. And so right now everything is just running off of a benchtop power supply. And so eventually there will be some kind of lithium ion or lithium polymer or something battery pack in the bottom of this. And so that's just temporary. I have built some very simple rudimentary power rails and stuff, but got a long way to go on a lot of that because I'm not really satisfied with it. And so anyway, that is an update on R2-D2. I'll see you in the next video. Do me a favor and subscribe to my channel and tap that like button. Thanks.